Hey, what's up, everybody? I hope you're having a blessed day today. Today, I'm actually able to post this particular video at the beginning of the day as opposed to the end of the day. I've got a lot going on today, but I wanted to go ahead and knock this out. Said I was going to do 30 days, and I'm going to commit to doing 30 days. So this day is a day that I'm excited about because this message is, again, just another phenomenal truth that I've learned over the last 52 years of living. This is the Troy DeGraw Chronicles, day 10 of 30, September the 10th, 2020. Here's the title, the focus of today's message: strife sabotages success. I want you to get that. Strife sabotages success. And that's what I want to talk about. I want to talk about the detriment and the danger of being in strife and how you have to be somebody that is mindful and on guard, that you keep strife out of your life. James, the third chapter, the 16th verse, says this: "For where envying and strife is, there is confusion and there is every evil work." Hold up. Wait a minute. What did I just read? James, the third chapter, the 16th verse says, "For where envying and strife is, there is confusion and evil work." Okay, guys, this is serious. If you have strife in you, because the Bible says wherever it is, so if strife is in you, then the Bible says that confusion is going to be in you. And maybe we could deal with some confusion, but this next thing, I don't want no parts of this. Every evil work will be in you. Not some evil work, but every evil work has permission to find residency in your life or wherever strife may be. This is why we cannot play with the subject or the idea of strife. Now, here's some synonyms for strife for those who may not be familiar with the word. Here's some synonyms for strife: conflict. You let me know if any of these sound familiar. Discord, disharmony, dissension, dissonance, disunion, disunity, division. Catch this one. Friction, infighting, oh my God, schisms, war, and warfare. Can anybody holler at me today? The Bible says, mayday, mayday, mayday. This is a warning of epic proportions. You cannot afford to have strife in your life because strife is a dangerous, dangerous culprit that you cannot invite and you cannot entertain. The reason why you cannot invite or entertain strife in your life is because strife never rolls alone. No. Strife's got some homies, and you don't want no part of the homies that strife runs with. Let me bless you with just a rundown of some of strife's homies. Pay attention to the partners that strife runs with. Not only does strife run with these partners I'm about to hit you with, but when you have strife in your life, strife opens up windows and doors and says, hey homies, come on in. I found a place to live. I found a place to reside. I found a place that allows me to be every single day in the heart and the minds and the soul of this individual. So you guys, come on in. Pay attention to the homies that roll with strife. Romans 1 and 29 gives us the list of strife's homies. Here it is, Romans 1 and 29. They have become filled with every kind of wickedness. There it is again, every kind of wickedness. And I could not help but notice Romans 1 and 29 says they will be filled, OMG.com. So we're not talking about just a little bit of this now. We're not talking about just a little bit of his homies, not just a few. We're talking about being filled to the brim with everything that runs with strife. Romans 1 and 29, check it out. I'm not making it up. They have become filled with every kind of wickedness. Okay, that's enough for me. I want to tap out right here. Can you imagine being filled with every kind of wickedness? But there's more. Filled with evil. Filled with greed. I'm simply reading Romans 1 and 29. Filled with depravity. Oh my God. Then it goes on to say they are also full of envy. Full of murder. And listen, this is not just talking about physical murder where you kill someone with your hands. We're talking about murder with your mouth. We're talking about murder in your mind. Filled with strife. filled with deceit, and then last but not least, filled with malice. These are the homies that run with strife. And you want to let that live in your life? You want to invite that in? Come on, and allow it to stay unchecked? Nah. If you got strife in your life today, let me tell you something. You need to serve some eviction notices and get all of them out. All the strifes, homies got to go. Everything that came with him got to go. Because what you don't recognize is that it is sabotaging your success. And you can do everything you can in life to try to be successful. But when God tells you there's certain things that sabotage your success, then you're really just wasting your energy. You're spinning tires because you won't deal with those issues that are eating away at your success. And strife is one of those issues. We have strife in our own families. We have strife with coworkers. We have strife with past lovers. We have strife with ex-husbands and ex-wives. Sometimes we have strife with our own children. Man, let me tell you something. It is a part of life, but it's a part of life you cannot ignore. And it's a part of life that you cannot let abide within your heart, your mind, your soul. You can't, because the damaging ripple effects of strife are crucial, guys. And there are people who will never be successful or who will never be able to maintain success. In other words, they get a taste of success, but they can't keep it. Why? Because strife is ruthless. Let me tell you why strife is so ruthless as I get ready to close. Strife gives Satan the permission to destroy your dreams, to ruin your relationships, and to keep you incarcerated in an unpleasant cell. That's what you do when you invite strife in. You allow strife to live within you. Him and all his homies come in and they have absolute permission to destroy your dreams. They have absolute permission to destroy your relationships. And you're the one that's giving them permission to keep you incarcerated in a cell. Let me tell you something, guys. I can't think of anything that's worth it. It's not worth it. It's not worth what it costs to be in strife with another individual. It's just not worth it. Now, I'm not just going to give you the wisdom and the knowledge about strife. I'm going to tell you what you need to do, because I want to see you free. I want to see you whole. I want to see you get out of that cell. I want to see your life bloom and blossom the way that God intended it. So here's what you got to do if you're serious about dealing with strife in your life. Number one, you have to forgive. Forgiveness is never about the person that you're forgiving. Forgiveness is always about your own freedom. Forgiveness is about you taking the shackles off of your hands, off of your neck, off of your feet. You getting rid of those chains that control you emotionally when you think about that person or when you see that person. You want to be free of that, because until you're free of that, you are a slave. As a matter of fact, you are that individual slave. You're the slave of strife. The only key, good God Almighty, that will unlock the chains of strife is the key of forgiveness. Take that key, stick it in the lock. I guarantee you, the chains will fall off of your life when you forgive every individual that you've been walking in strife with. Some have been walking in strife with people for years. There are people who are actually walking in strife with people who are dead and gone. Come on, get those chains off your life. It's not worth it. Number two, after you forgive, this is critical and important. You have to adjust and modify. Here's what I mean by adjust and modify after you forgive. Just because you forgive someone doesn't mean that you need to be in contact with them. That's rich. Just because you've forgiven someone doesn't mean you have to let them back into your home. It doesn't even mean you have to let them back into your life. No, what forgiveness means is that I'm no longer going to be manipulated and pimped by the negative emotions and the negative feelings that had taken residence in my mind, my heart, my soul. That's all that simply means. The second portion of that is, okay, now that I've forgiven you, I'm not stupid. I forgave you, but I didn't forget. Okay, so now I'm going to make some adjustments. I'm going to adjust how I operate, how I deal with you. I'm going to adjust how you and I interact based on what you've shown me and who you've shown me to be. This is rich revelation information. Then number three, because I got to go. Number one, forgive. Number two, adjust and modify. the relationship and how you interact with that person. And here's number three, maybe the most important one of the three. Number three, love that individual. Love that individual and then catch this in parentheses, perhaps from a safe distance. Ooh, 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 ooh. See, we don't teach this thing the way we should teach it. I'm teaching it the way it should be taught, that there are some people in this life that you are going to have to love from a distance. Yeah, it means I love you. I love you. We're not buddy-buddy. We don't talk every day. We're not the best of friends. But if you search my heart, you will find no animosity, no evil, no hate, no dislike towards you, because I'm free of that now. So I'm going to love you, but I'm going to love you from a safe distance. I'm going to love you from a safe distance because you've shown me who you are and what you are. We spend too much time trying to convert people to be what we want them to be, when it has been said over and over again, when somebody shows you who they are, you got one job: believe them. And then make the adjustments and the modifications, because if that's what they want to be and that's who they want to be, it's your duty to respect them, not to encroach upon their personality or their character and try to force them to be something that they're not. No, respect them, but give them the space to be what they want to be of who they're trying to be. Don't jive and fit with who you're called to be. Good God Almighty. And this is today's lesson about how strife sabotages your success. I hope you've enjoyed it. If so, let me know. Also, be a digital disciple and share this with somebody else. You guys have a great day.